Good morning students and welcome to our e-learning session for class 8. And as you know, since last two lectures we are talking chapter number 8, that is India, challenges and solutions. Number of things what we have already discussed, we learn, we talk and we understand the different challenges what the India is facing. As India is a vast country, geographically we are having a great extent, religiously, linguistic and all type of diversity like the geographical also. So when we are having a such a wonderful diversity, obviously there will be the number of challenges. Even in India, we are having a large population. Yes, so we are a second largest populated country. So due to this all factors, number of challenges what we are facing. So we have talked about the few challenges, that is like the, we did the classification of challenges. Yes, in that we talk about the internal problems, regional problems, border problems and natural problems. And further we divided this problem like particular topic what we have discussed, that is overpopulation and internal problem I am talking. So the overpopulation, illiteracy, inflation, poverty, unemployment, urbanization, communalism, corruption and terrorism. In regional problem again we will going to discuss about the discrimination based on the language, as we are having a great linguistic diversity. Yes, and the regionalism, that what we will going to discuss. Then the border problem, as we know, India share its boundary, land boundary with the 7 countries and land water boundaries. So altogether we are having a 9 neighbors, so number of problems we are facing. And the natural problem, that is a flood, famine, tsunami, volcanic eruption and the cyclone. Yes. So few month back we experienced taute. Yes, so this all are the natural problem that what we face. So before we start a new topic, let's talk what we have previously discussed, that what we have discussed about the major problem about the literacy, illiteracy. Illiteracy is the major problem which is faced by our country. Due to the overpopulation, due to the poverty, number of people, due to any of the reason, they are not getting a good education. So what is the meaning of education or educate? At least they can read or write any one language. Read or write any one language, we consider him or her as like, you know, literate. But in our country, due to number of reason like the poverty, overpopulation, schools are far away, due to the economical condition, thousands of people are still illiterate in our country, and this is the internal problem. If we are having a good literacy rate, we can say we can more develop. Yes, so in that after overpopulation we have discussed about the illiteracy. So here you can see on the board that the illiteracy is the major factor hindering the progress of a nation. It's a major problem which is hindering our development. As all the citizens are not literate, so their mindset is not well developed. Things, thoughts, belief. Yes, so this is the major issue. So literacy is required to understand new ideas. Why we have to study? What is the importance? See students, you are blessed. You are the future of this nation. And as now you have a rational thinking, your thoughts, your idea, if you compare yourself with others, those who are not literate, so you can specify the difference between you and other person as you are more literate. So what makes this change? What a good idea you are having? So the literacy is required to understand the new ideas, discoveries and knowledge. An educated person can effectively communicate and explain his ideas, opinions, views and beliefs. We can express ourselves. Until unless if we can't express ourselves, how can we communicate with others? So when we are literate, we can do it very nicely. Then when we attained the independence, the illiteracy rate was quite low. If we talk about the 1947, when we got independence, at that time Indian literacy rate was very low. But due to the government policies, number of schools, now we are having private as well as the public schools. So we are having a good literacy rate now. So, but due to the efforts of the government, awareness toward education has increased and the literacy rate has gone up in the country. Then important major issue what we discussed was about the poverty. So in poverty, how can we describe the poverty? So poverty, it means like, you know, it's another major challenge of our country. So that is a situation when a person is not able to fulfill his or her basic requirement. So what we can say, a situation when a person is deprived. The word what we are using, it's a deprived. So when the person is deprived of a basic necessity like the food, clothing, shelter, employment, medical facilities is termed as the poverty. So the percentage of people in Gujarat living below the poverty line is 14.7%. See, when I explain this about the poverty, I told you to underline it and see the proportion. Though India is a developed state, then also in Gujarat, we are having 14.7% of poor people, those who are living in our Gujarat state. So poverty, as I said, when the person is deprived from the basic requirement, we consider him or her as poor. The percentage of people in Gujarat living below the poverty line, that is a very important point. Again, I am focusing you. Please understand and please making a note. So the criteria of poverty are set on the basis of purchasing capacity, that per capita income and the purchasing capacity. This all are the wonderful points that you should understand, and thoroughly we will going to discuss very nicely in class 10th. Okay, so capacity and level of income. Due to the 5-year plan, education and medical facility have become the more accessible in India. Moreover, the growth of industries has created lots of job opportunities, which consequently has reduced the poverty. Now this all are the steps why how it's less, or now what are the measures what we can say. So this all are the steps which are taken by the government actually, and the income of people has increased due to the integration of technology in agriculture and other profession. Now see, agriculture means kheti. India, most of the population previously was, most of the population was like, you know, belong or they occupied their work in the farming or the agriculture. So now the proportion is low now, but still number of the citizens are depend on this. So moreover, the growth of industries has created lot of job opportunities like in agriculture and in the other profession. Now the point what we have to talk is about the corruption. Corruption word you all know. Corruption lena means what? Corruption, you might be have seen the Gabbar movie of Akshay Kumar. You know, to do any work, one particular official, government official, is like, you know, taking the corruption, like illegal money. So that what we say is it's a corruption. So corruption in a simple term means a lack of integrity or honesty. Integrity means what? You must be very much faithful towards your system, towards the government, towards the citizen. But it is showing the lacking in this criteria. So please underline it. Corruption is, in a simple term, It's a lack of integrity or honesty. Use of position of trust for dishonest gain. If say for someone is in having a higher position in government office and he or she asks for gift or money to do particular work, as government servant is a public servant, he or she must work for the betterment of the nation, for the betterment of the public, betterment of the people, but he or she is not performing duty in a proper manner. They are going with the dishonest or unfair practices. If they ask for particular monetary refund, monetary thing, or for the gift, this all system, this thing what we can say is a corruption. In India, we can't say that only in India, but most on the department, now it's very less in proportion, but still corruption is a major problem of our country, and even it's a global problem what we can say. So it means the dishonest behavior by those in position of power, such as the managers of government officials. Corruption can be included giving or accepting. See, as a citizen, if I want to work, if I want to do some work, I want some help from government, and if I'm giving some gift or money to the government official, so I'm also including this corruption. So giving and taking, both are culprit. Yes, so corruption can include giving or accepting bribes or the improper, inappropriate gifts, double dealing, under the table transaction. Under the table transaction matlab, you are giving some gift or money to do your work, or on the behalf of your company or anything, when you are giving illegal things, that what you can say. So that is the bribes or the inappropriate gifts, double dealing, under the table transaction, manipulating election, diverting funds, laundering money, jisko hum kehte kala dhan. Yes, laundering money, defrauding investors. Corruption has become the major issue that hinders the development of our nation. So this point, please, it means, do underline, or in your material, in your, if right now you are sitting with your material or textbook, please pay your attention. It means the dishonest behavior by those in position of power, such as the manager or government official. Corruption can include giving or accepting. It is not only giving, or it is not only the accepting, but the givers and takers, both are the same, they are doing the crime. Okay. So as a manager or the governors, official, corruption can include giving or accepting bribes or the inappropriate gifts, double dealing, under the table. This all are we include in the corruption. Yes. So this all term you must understand. So double dealing, then the under table transaction, elections, diverting funds, and defrauding investors. Corruption has become the major issue that hinders the development of our nation. So this point you have to keep in mind when we talk about the corruption. Now, effect of corruption, why it is problem for our country, not only for our country, but for the all. What are the point? So corruption leads to the following ill effect. What are the effect we face? Violence of the human rights. This is the utmost important effect. Violence of the human right. Say for if particular person is not able to give extra money or the corruption, he or she will not able to fulfill his or her requirement. Yes, if violence, this what we can say, this is the violence of the human rights. As citizen of this globe, as citizen of any particular nation, it's a government duty to fulfill basic requirement of the citizen of the nation. But as particular people are against this corruption, or they are not able to give the correction, they should not deprived from the basic rights. Yes, so violence of the human right, this is the first and utmost effect of the corruption. Then the hindrance to the development of the nation. See, when we are doing any particular job, then it is our moral duty. It is our moral duty to fulfill the basic requirement or the work what we are doing. See, as teacher, this is my duty to do my work in the best manner at my best knowledge. Likewise, all the person, those who are engaged with the public work, whether they are in the service sector, whether they are in like any sector, they have to work for the betterment of the citizen. If the citizen are not having the moral value, if they are engaged in this type of social problem like the corruption, it is a hindrance to the development of nation. It is not about the matter of one or two person, but ultimately it affects the development of the nation. See, I am explaining you in the class also that we have to be very much sensible, responsible citizen of the nation. As this is our country, we are the future of this nation. So we have to be very much ethical. We must follow the moral values. So this point what we have to keep in mind. So what is the most important effect of the corruption? That is the hindrance of the development of the nation. Then comes the deterioration of the moral value. Now, when one person is engaged with the corruption, he or she is taking a corruption, any corruption activities he or she is doing, the moral value, what the moral value he or she will have. So what we can say, it's a deterioration of the moral value. For money, you can do anything. For sake of few money, sake of like, you know, money, you have to face any type of problem. Your work will not do done in a proper time. So just sake of the money, the number of like, you know, the moral value, you will not see in the deterioration of the moral value. This is the problem what we can say. Then come the inflation, price rise. Now you just thought, if someone is doing corruption and how it affects to the inflation. Inflation, that what we have learned, isn't it? So corruption, when any person is doing the corruption, obviously that for that particular job, a particular work, for particular service, there will be the price rise. So that what we say is in sense, general sense, we can say it's a inflation. Then lack of trust in law. लोगों का सरकार पे कायदों पे विश्वास न रहना. सो इफ एनी पर्सन, एनी ऑफिशियल, एनी गवर्नमेंट डिपार्टमेंट इज करप्टेड, द यू नो द ट्रस्ट ऑफ द पीपल विल नॉट देयर. पीपल विल नॉट फॉलो द रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन, इवन एज वी डू नॉट हैव द ट्रस्ट ऑन द गवर्नमेंट सिस्टम ओनली. सो अल्टीमेटली दिस इज द लाइक यू नो ultimately this is the loss of our country. So never give give anything like giving or accepting, this both we can say this is the corruption. So we should not practice this type of things. Then encouragement to nepotism. Now here the bureaucracy, the officers, those who are engaged with this public work, like you know, they will have the particular bureaucracy thought, even they will go with the ill practices. So this is the very important point why the corruption is harmful, or what are the like you know adverse effect of corruption what we can say. Slow human development and breach of faith. You don't have the faith then. as if every public department or the private department, but most probably the public department, if they are engaged with this type of activities, illegal practices, no one will have faith in this system further. So ultimately, this is the loss of our country, loss of faith, loss of trust. Yes. So what are the measures? So government has framed the certain laws. Government has framed the certain laws since 1988. Okay, so 1988 you have to keep in mind. And to reduce and prevent the corruption, Anti-Corruption Bureau, double underline, Anti-Corruption Bureau, 1988. So government has framed certain laws since 1988 to prevent corruption. Anti-Corruption Bureau has been formed in the year 1964. Anti-Corruption Bureau has framed in 1964. It helps the people in checking and controlling corruption. If we are having any queries, if someone is asking for the any kind of illegal practice, or if someone is doing so, we can make a complaint against that department, against that person. Yes. So this is what the corruption is all about. Now, one activity is given in your textbook. So let's check in it. Collect corruption related news from newspaper and discuss it in the class. Now, as we are having online sessions, online classes, so this activity even you can do with your parents or with your friend on phone. So you have to collect the corruption related news. Like, you know, you must read the newspaper. As you know, it's very important to read the newspaper. So in newspaper, now and then, or on regular, most of time you will have this type of news, that number of illegal practices, one or other form of the corruption. So you have to collect the corruption's news and you can discuss. Even further, you can take a guidance from your parents either. Find the address of Anti-Corruption Bureau in your district. So Bhavnagar is a district. Bhavnagar is headquarter. So in our, you have to find where the Anti-Corruption Bureau is located. So this is your first homework. This activity is given in your textbook. So this is your homework first. First homework, huh? As I told you, in between lecture also I will give you the homework. And you have to send it on the time. Okay. So what you have to do? Find the address of Anti-Corruption Bureau in your district. But what the message we have to learn? As citizen of this nation, as this is my citizen, this is our citizen. When it belongs to us, this is our responsibility to take care of the things, take care of the nation. So what the message we have to keep in the mind? Accepting and offering bribes, both are crime. Accepting and giving. Dena or lena, rishwat. Bribes matlab rishwat. Dena or lena. So accepting and offering bribes, both are crime. Now, after few years, you will become doctor, renowned doctor, engineer. Many of you are having dreaming to become the IAS IPS officer. You want to clear your UPSC exam. At that time, you will have some power. You will be in that position. So, what thing you will keep in mind? Accepting and offering bribe. It's a, both are crime. So, keep in mind. Now, let's talk on things to know. What point we have to keep in mind? See, know about the legal procedure to prevent corruption and bribery. What are the points you have to keep in mind? It's a given. So director, to whom we can make our complaint? To the director, Anti-Corruption Bureau, bungalow number 17, Dafnala. To whom we can make a written complaint? So what is the address? It is given. Director, Anti-Corruption Bureau, bungalow number 17, Dafnala, Shahibagh, Ahmedabad. Again, I am repeating the address: Director, Anti-Corruption Bureau, Bungalow Number 17, Dafnada, Shahi Bagh, Ahmedabad. Please write the PIN code: 380003. 380003. And the phone number what you can use it for: 079. This is a code, SD code of Ahmedabad actually. So 079-2286-0341. Okay, so this is the another major problem. Now, before we talk about the unemployment, as it is a major issue, let's first talk on the terrorism. Take a 1 minute to think. Every day we are come across with this word terrorism, isn't it? Terrorism, Ugravad, Atankvad. We all have seen the movie like the Uri, the surgical strike, terrorist attack on the Pathankot. Every day our military in Jammu and Kashmir, even in the Seven Sisters region, our police and our armed forces are facing the terrorist attack. Might be you have seen the movie 9/11. America, Twin Tower, might be you have read, you have seen the clips, you have seen the movies. Terrorism is a global problem. Entire world is facing this problem. But as India, like you know, the major issue for India, as thousands and crore of rupees are wasting daily, and our soldiers and police, like you know, they are losing their life. So terrorism is a global problem. Terrorist activities are an obstacle in the progress of nation. It is not that that particular region or that particular state or that particular city is, like you know, have suffering from that, but entire nation and entire world is suffering from this problem of terrorism. It is an evil effort to disturb the peace, brotherhood and unity of nation. Ultimately, irrespective of any caste, creed, we all are same, we are human. But terrorism on the base of religion, it's a social evil and it's against to the human rights. It's destroyed, disturbed the brotherhood, integrity, unity of a nation. So terrorism is a global problem. Terrorist activities are an obstacle in the progress of nation, isn't it? It is an evil effort to disturb the peace, brotherhood and unity of nation. Terrorism inflicts fear in people. Ek dar ka mahol hota hai. Because you, no one knows ke what will get, what will happen next. So absolute, it's a high risky area or the high zone you will have to stay. So you will have mental as well as the pressure and the stress you have to face it. So the global goal of terrorism is never scared. Sacred nahi hota. It's not a sacred, ye pavitra nahi hai. They are not a human. They do not have the human feeling at all. If any person is Hindu or Musliman, Indian or Pakistan, ultimately we all are the human being. So what you can say for the terrorism? The goal of terrorism is never sacred. Sacred matlab pavitra, kabhi nahi ho sakta. Achha intention kabhi nahi ho sakta. So the goal of terrorism is never sacred, pure or good. How can anyone hurt? How anyone can kill any person on the basis of religion, on the basis of country? how this intention can be good or the sacred. Terrorism is an inhuman act carried out by the certain group of people in planned way. Terrorism is always in the planned way. It is not accidental. If someone want to attack somewhere, so you have to make plan. It is not an accidental. So it is a well-planned terrorist activities. So in real sense, we can say that it's a horrible challenge for any country. So terrorism is a global problem, as well as terrorist activities are an obstacle in the progress of the nation. And in all efforts to disturb the peace, brotherhood, unity of nation, terrorism inflicts the fear in the people through the violence and hatred. The goal of terrorism is never sacred, pure or good. So terrorism as an inhuman act carried by the certain group of people in a planned way, it's resort to bullying, killing, torturing somebody. Kya hota hai? It's a simple manner. It's a bullying. It's like, you know, to kill someone, to hurt someone. This is actually plan, and this is the way how the terrorist done their practice. They are performing their activities, so called. So terrorism is a challenge for any government. So terrorism is a challenge for any government. Terrorism an easy way to display powers forcefully. Now you know about the Taliban. If you remember, when on 15th of August 2021, Taliban captured the Kabul. On that day also I have explained you in the class. So Taliban Raj is also a terrorist activity. I have explained you very nicely. We have fine discussion on that day. Yes, so terrorism an easy way to display power forcefully. Innocent people become a target of massacres anywhere. Every day in a world, thrice, four times in a week, you know, there will be the bomb blast in Afghanistan, might be in Jammu Kashmir. So this all are the by like, no, innocent peoples are killed by this type of activities. So terrorism an easy way to display the power forcefully. Innocent people become the target of massacres anywhere. In the past, there were the terrorist attack on the parliament, Indian parliament, Ajmal Kasab, we have talked this also. Hotel Taj, Mumbai share market, local train, and on Akshardham, in our Gandhinagar Akshardham temple. India is a victim of this type of terrorist attack. Terrorism is a pure hearted and crucially. It has got nothing to do with the kinsman, religion or the language. Koi dharma. No religion, no caste, no country. It's against the human right. It's against to the human, culture or the faith or the belief. No religion teach such type of rubbish thing, isn't it? So, now, as India is facing terrorism, so what steps, what measures are taken by the government? So we have to face it with the bravery and courage. We have to be, as we are also part of this country. This is my country. This is our country. How can we tolerate this type of nonsense? So we have to be very much courageous. We have to face it with a very, bravery, and like we have to very courageously, we have to face it. The intelligence bureau of the nation should be strong and active. Awareness regarding cooperating with the security agencies has to be developed. We should not support in any manner to this terrorist activity. This is our responsibility. This is our responsibility. We can't, we can't say that this is the government duty. Government is helping to us. Government is helping. But we can't say that it's purely the government duty. As citizen of this nation, it's our duty as well. So people have to be very alert at the public or crowded places. If you say any unusual thing, any person, anything, you must inform to police. This is our responsibility as a citizen. We have to show the awareness. So one must not pay attention to the rumors. Rumors matlab kana fusi ya to koi bhi baatein ghum ghaam ke aati hai. So we should not rumors. We should not follow or believe on the rumors. Should not panic. डर का माहौल नहीं पैदा करना है. वी शुड नॉट पैनिक इन द टाइम ऑफ क्राइसिस. द सिक्योरिटी फोर्सेस शुड बी वेल इक्विप्ड विद सीसीटीवी कैमरास एंड मेटल डिटेक्टर्स. इफ समवन इज हैविंग अ गन और द नाइफ और एनीथिंग देन वन शुड बी इफ दिस देयर विल बी द सीसीटीवी कैमरा दिस इज हेल्पफुल. इवन द विद द मेटल डिटेक्टर वी कैन बी एनीवन कैन बी चेक्ड. Apart from this, various other changes, challenges even we face. So we must not be the panic in the time of crisis. Then the security forces should be well equipped with the CCTV and cameras and the metal detectors. We all know about this point. Apart from this, various other challenges faced by the nation are orthodoxy. Purane vichar, like you know, number of time if cat cross the road, it's a bad luck. If someone sneeze for one in a odd number 1, 3, 5, it's a brings a bad luck. This is rubbish thing. So orthodoxy, communalism. Hindu are better than Muslims. Muslims are better than Hindus. This all are the rubbish thought. We ultimately we are humans. Regionalism, as we live in Gujarat, so Gujarati people are better than Biharis or the Rajasthani regional about your region. Then discrimination based on the languages. Gujarati is the finest or other languages the finest compared to other linguistic. Then border issued, like India is better than other country. It is not. All are having their own sovereignty. After the natural disaster, rehabilitation after the natural disaster, this is also a one of the major issue that what we will going to talk in next chapter lecture. Study this in detail and try to know the possible solution to this problem with the help of your teacher. So with me, with your parents, we will discuss. And my dear student, you are the future of this nation. This is your country. When it belongs to you, when it belongs to us, we have to be very much sensible. We have to be respectful towards the every situation and every challenges. And definitely we will change our country. Our country in past Vishwaguru, at present it is our responsibility. And definitely together we will make this change. So it's a time for homework. Please write your homework. Question number 1, which institution checks and controls the corruption? That what we have discussed right now. Yes, so which institution checks and controls the corruption? Second question, which problems are cities facing? In city, big city like the Mumbai, Ahmedabad, Delhi, what type of problem it's they are facing? Define the terrorism. What is terrorism? That what we have discussed. Then what is the full form of BPL? If you remember in previous lecture we have discussed about the BPL. I told you to write this. So again this concept you have to be very much, you have to clear this concept, what is a BPL. Then comes explain the poverty and mention the measure to solve it. You have to be very much clear about the poverty, concept of poverty, and you have to make it very much clear. So explain the poverty and mention the measure to solve it. So this is your homework. In next lecture we will going to talk about the another problem about the unemployment, as this is very serious problem. In detail we have to talk. And in last we will go and we'll talk about the few more challenges. Though it is not given in your material or, but it is a mention in your book. So I would like to give you some idea of that things. So in next lecture we will going to continue with the same content and the concept. Then we'll start another chapter. Today, as in the beginning I have not discussed that, but I am thinking and I am sure that you all have enjoyed your Makar Sankrant Uttarayan day. I am hoping and I know that you wrote the bird helpline number. Might be you have saved few birds. So write your experience. This is the writing task. Write your experience, what you did on Uttarayan. So today is Tuesday. On Thursday, last Thursday, you enjoyed. We had a kite flying day. So you have to write in a one page and you have to draw some beautiful drawing, as it's create imagination, and like, you know, by drawing and by your own writing, we have to come up with the more, like, you know, imagination and the words. So what was your experience for the Uttarayan, that what you have to write. So few tasks I have assigned you, homework you have to do it, one activity I have given you, and this time you have to write, it should be like my experience point you have to mention. So in next lecture we'll continue this chapter. Take care. Thank you.